Clam Festival this morning. Those are the Down East Barbershoppers singing the national anthem to kick off this year's festival. It's free, but here are some numbers for you. Every year, festival goers eat an estimated 6,000 pounds of clams, 6,000 lobster rolls, and 6,000 strawberry shortcakes. The Yarmouth Chamber of Commerce president says some people have been coming to the Clam Festival since it started nearly a half century ago.
It started with a few community members putting together a little picnic and a little lobster bake right here on the property, and it's just grown year over year. Some of the people that are still around from 48 years ago say, oh my gosh, we've taken over the town for one weekend every year.
Organizers are expecting more than 100,000 people to visit this weekend. And meantime, after a tragic accident that left a man dead during Bangor's 4th of July parade, what kind of safety measures are in place in Yarmouth to keep parade spectators and participants safe? WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is live in Yarmouth tonight with more on that story. Jim?
Well, Paul, first off, some 40,000 people expected to turn out for this parade, which is expected to start any moment now. There were about 40 antique cars, and we're told about a half a dozen of those vintage fire trucks in this parade. And festival organizers are doing all they can to keep people safe.
They claim their viewing spots with lawn chairs. Close to the road, maybe, but the Yarmouth Clam Festival organizers say there are safety procedures in place to keep everybody safe.
A part of the rules that we have is we don't allow anything to be thrown off of floats or thrown into the crowds or passed out, so we hope that that also helps to eliminate anybody running into the street.
Nobody wants a repeat of the tragic accident that happened in Bangor during its 4th of July parade. Police said an antique fire truck had some kind of brake malfunction, causing it to lose control. The fire truck ran over a vintage John Deere tractor and its driver, who was killed instantly. At the Freeport Firehouse today, retired firefighter Bob Fesselman is polishing up the 1939 American LaFrance, considered the town's first fire truck. It will be among the antique vehicles in the Yarmouth Clam Festival parade today. He says it's left to the town to make sure the truck is in good working order.
We have our town crew, our town maintenance people. We look at it every year. They work the town garage. They're certified mechanics. They work in all the town vehicles, the fire trucks, the police cruisers.
Maine Secretary of State says there is no state law requiring these types of vehicles be inspected. A car or truck considered antique if it's 25 years old or older. The only regulation on the books are that the antique vehicles be in their original condition and the owners cannot use them as a primary vehicle. Along the Yarmouth parade route today, Pam Utley and her family calling the Bangor incident a freak accident, one they hope doesn't happen here.
Yeah, I think you can't always anticipate something like that happens. And I think the best that you can do is make a plan to prevent it in the future. And I'm sure that they have done that here.
Another bit of information we learned from the Secretary of State's office is this. Whatever happened to all those small town parades, the Memorial Day parades, the 4th of July parades? Well, Matt Dunlap says that the smaller towns don't have them anymore because they can't get or afford the liability insurance. Live in Yarmouth tonight, Jim Keithley, WMTW News.